16,144, which is great. You know, I'm not sure. That's a good question. I'll get that answer to you shortly. That's a good question. And another note real quick, the rebroadcast of Mayweather Maidana 2 will be next Saturday, September 20th at 9 p.m. Eastern, 6 Pacific, and it's going to be immediately following the All Access Mayweather Maidana 2 epilogue.
Buenas noches, muchas gracias. Bueno, estoy muy contento de haber peleado dos veces con Floyd Mayweather.
Good evening. Thank you all for being here. Well, I want to first say that I'm very happy to have fought twice against Floyd Mayweather.
He hecho un trabajo muy lindo. Muchos boxeadores han peleado con él, nunca le hicieron lo que yo le hice, nunca le pegaron como le pegué.
I think I did a terrific job. Many fighters have fought against him, and you know, I don't think they've done what I've been able to do and land so many punches against Floyd Mayweather.
Yo siento que la pelea que he hecho salí ganador, victorioso, pero bueno, si los jueces prefieren a un correlón como Floyd, está bien.
I felt that I did enough to win. I felt I did enough to win, but what can I say? If the judge is like a fighter that runs like Floyd, then there's nothing I can do about that.
Bueno, muchas gracias y nos volveremos a ver aquí en Las Vegas.
Once again, thank you very much, and we'll see you guys again, once again here in Las Vegas.
Eric got a question for you.
So we're going to open up for questions now. Wait, before... questions. Before we start asking questions, I want to bring up Robert Garcia, the trainer. I think he did a terrific job with Gino these last couple of years. He deserves a lot of credit. He's one of the best trainers in our sport. Robert Garcia, say a few words. Robert?
Good night to everybody. You know, we, once again, obviously didn't take the decision, but I am, you know, very proud to say that, you know, Chino Maidana, a one-dimensional fighter who nobody ever thought would be in this position, has fought Mayweather twice, and has been able to do what he's done in both fights. I am very, very happy that everybody came to support Mayweather for giving us the opportunity. We are blessed to be where we are right now, and this is just the beginning. I think there's so many big things for Chino in the future. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. So we'll open up to questions.
Gino, first question for you.
Gino,
do you think that you gave the blueprint, even though you didn't win either of the fights, to other fighters that may face Floyd in the future to be able to beat him, showing him the way you attack him?
Yo creo que sí, que se le puede ganar, hay que pelearlo, atacarlo nada más y no saber qué hacer.
Yes, that's true. I think he's beatable, I think you have to attack him more and more, and when you attack him, you know, he doesn't really know what to do.
Chino, I wonder, he landed 58% of his power punches and 51% of his punches overall. So he had a significantly higher percentage landed punches than you. Do you think it was the fact that his speed was too much and you couldn't hit him as much as you would want to because that it initiated that 166-128?
No, para nada. No pude contragolpearlo y también... es rápido de pierna, pero lo pude golpear.
No, not at all. It didn't bother me. You know, I was able to counter him, actually. I was able to counter him, and he's very fast on his feet, I'll tell you that.
Two other things. Can you explain from your standpoint what happened in the center of the ring in the eighth round when it appeared you bit him?
La verdad que yo en ningún momento sentí que lo mordí, no. Él sí me metía los dedos en el ojo y no, yo no sentí que lo mordí.
No, not at all. I didn't bite him. That didn't happen. I didn't bite him. I think that he poked my eye. I did feel that when he had his glove in my face. But no, I didn't bite him.
And then, Mr. Garcia, I just wanted to ask you, when you're in the corner and you know Mayweather's landing at a much higher percentage, does that affect you at all, or do you feel like Chino's pressure made the difference because, the connect percentage was so much, vastly different?
Well, we were asking Chino to put a lot of pressure. Obviously, that's the way we're effective. We landed punches when we had Floyd in the corner, so we just kept reminding him to put pressure. And, the fight was a close fight, and Floyd was doing his job. You know, he's been the best for the last 10 years. What can we do?
Okay, more questions. Dan.
Hey, Chino. Robert, question for him, or Eric, whoever's going to translate. He's now had two fights, high-profile fights with Floyd Mayweather. He went the distance. He was competitive, certainly, in the first one. Maybe not as much so tonight, but still, fun fight to watch. What does he think it does for him, even though he has two losses in a row, what it does for him going forward with so many other, quality fighters in the weight class that he can mix up with and make exciting fights for fans and make money for himself? Robert, you can answer that too, what you want to do.
Yo creo que, no, me siento muy contento del trabajo que hice. Le he dado batalla a Floyd Mayweather que casi ningún boxeador le ha pegado tanto como le pegué yo.
Look, I'm very satisfied with my performances against him. I did very well, I feel, against him, and I feel that I connected and landed too many punches that the other fighters weren't able to.
Yo creo que no sé, pero creo que estoy para pelear con cualquiera.
I think I'm fine. I'm still at the same level. I think I'm ready to fight anybody. I can fight anybody at that level.
With two fights against Floyd and the performances that we did, I think Chino's in great position for great fights. There's so many big names out there that fight in the welterweight division. I'm sure Sebastián Contursia and Alvin will find something great in the future. There's nothing to be ashamed of. We fought the best, and I think we did a great job both times. So we're in a great position right now.
Rick.
And Chino, in the first fight, you admitted that you got tired in the second half. How did you feel in the second half of this fight?
En la primera pelea.
Sí, en la primera pelea bajé un poco el ritmo del quinto round para adelante, sexto. En esta me preparé muy bien, sabía que iba a ser una pelea dura como la anterior y tuve bien 12 rounds.
Yes, you're right. In the first fight, I my rhythm stopped. I slowed down. But in this fight, I felt that I fought hard 12 rounds, and I felt a lot better.
And I was going to ask Robert, going into those final two rounds, did you think that Maidana may need a knockout or knock him down to get the decision? Did you think it was close? Did you think you were ahead?
No, we knew the fight was close, but we pushed him to finish strong, and that's what he did. He finished strong. I think those last couple of rounds were clearly his. It was a very close fight. It was a very competitive fight. Something, like he just said, like he told you earlier, something that nobody else, great fighters that are going to be in Hall of Fame haven't been able to do with him. He's been able to do something like that. We're honestly very proud of what we accomplished with Chino.
Did you think it was closer this time around than the first fight?
I think both fights were very close. Mayweather's also a very smart fighter. He fights very well. He boxes really good. That's why he's the best.
Chino, acá Ernesto Rodríguez de Olén.
Okay.
Ya no vamos a estar. Primero un recuerdo. Para todos los presentes, hoy en Argentina, ahora, empieza el Día del Boxeador recordando el 23 de septiembre de 1921 cuando Luis Ángel Firpo derribó del ring a Jack Dempsey en una pelea, la primera pelea del siglo. ¿Cómo son tus sensaciones de haber vuelto a parar el mundo, de haber estado en el centro de la atención contra el mejor boxeador libra por libra?
The question is, let me go ahead and translate. The question was that it was today in Argentina to celebrate the Day of the Boxer, and that back in the turn of the century,
Filippo fought against Jack Dempsey, and it was a big thing in Argentina. How do you feel that you performed today and you fought against the best fighter in the world, pound for pound?
Bueno, muy contento de volver a pelear con Floyd Mayweather y no, muy contento por el apoyo de la gente y bueno, traté de brindar todo lo posible y traté de ganar, pero no pude. Pero bueno, yo creo que espero que le haya gustado a toda la Argentina, a todo mi público, a toda la gente que me apoya.
I'm very happy. I'm very happy with my performance. I gave it my all. I tried to win. I really tried to win. You know, I hope that my fans and my followers are happy with my performance. I did what I could to win, and I came up short.
Chino, ¿cómo te sentís viendo la pelea, viendo que el referee te descuenta un punto por una palanca con la que terminás derribando 50 a Mayweather, y en el round siguiente recibís un golpe limpio, bajo, claro, y Mayweather solo recibe un apercibimiento y no le quitan puntos?
How do you feel? The question is, how do you feel that they took away a point from you, and then the following round, Floyd did, you know, he landed a low blow, and then they just gave him a warning.
Bueno, la verdad que la palanca, yo puse el codo como lo pone él y él se dejó caer. No fue que yo lo tiré ni nada y bueno, y ahí el árbitro me descontó puntos que no tendría que haberme descontado.
Well, I mean, when they took away the point from me, I don't think that I did it purposely. You know, I was just trying to get away. He fouled on his own. I didn't push him down. But it is what it is.
Y la última es para el Chino y para Sebastián. ¿Se les puede entregar la posibilidad de volver a Las Vegas? ¿Ya tienen alguna propuesta, Chino o Sebastián Contursi?
The question is for Sebastián Contursi. Would you guys consider coming back to Vegas and fighting again?
No hay nada de teniendo un peleador como Maidana, siempre va a haber propuestas para el mejor nivel, porque él está en el mejor nivel, pero me parece que también se merece un descansito. Todos nos lo merecemos.
No, yeah, the answer was, look, having a fighter like Chino Maidana, there's always going to be great offers, there's always going to be opportunities to fight here in Las Vegas, and we're going to take a look at him and make a decision. Okay, so guys, thank you very much. Thank you for being here. Chino, thank you very much. Round of applause. You fought a great fight. Yes. So now before Floyd gets here, I want to bring up the undefeated world champion, Leo Santa Cruz, successful defense of his title with the second round knockout. Leo.
Muy buenas noches a todos, good evening to everybody. I just want to say that thank you all for the support, for everything you guys been doing for me, and I'm just very happy, and all the hard work that we did in the gym paid off.
Okay, great. Thank you. We're going to open up for questions for Leo Santa Cruz. Anyone?
Hi, Leo. Congratulations.
Thank you.
It's a nice knockout. You know, we talked about it before the fight that your opponent, although a hard worker and a guy that you figured would come to fight, was really not at your level. You basically did what you were supposed to do. Is it now time for you to have a defining fight at 122 pounds?
Yeah, that's what we're going to look for. I think we did what we had to do. We just trained hard in the gym and we had to finish the fight like that. But yeah, I think my next fight, I want Rivendux or Frampton or Quick. I think I'm ready for those fights. And as long as the promoter and my manager, they get along with the other camp and make it happen, I'm willing to prepare anything.
Thank you.
Eric, I had a question for you. Leo seems to really be focused on the Rigondeaux fight. Rigondeaux doesn't have a promoter, really. Is that a makeable fight? You think that fight could happen?
Anybody. I mean, Leo's the guy that's always fought anybody. We've never had any problems making fights for Leo. Anybody we present to him, he'll... They've never said no. So, I mean, I think it's a matter of getting together with Steven Espinoza, Al Heyman, see what's the best move for him. Obviously, he wants to fight the best in the division. He deserves it. I think that it's just a matter of getting down to business and, you know, seeing numbers, and it's all in the negotiations. Questions for Leo? He's hungry. He wants to go get tacos, right?
Tacos, yeah.
Any questions? Thank you guys. Thank you very much. Thank you, Leo. Congratulations once again.
Promoter, knowing what the obstacles are with negotiations, have any hope that it can be made?
Of course you have hope, because it's all about giving the fans what they want to see. We would love to fight him. We all know what the obstacles have been in the past, but you just put all that behind you and just hopefully you get together and make it happen.
Were you surprised to hear him say that?
Not at all.
Leonard, Ken Miller with the Sentinel newspaper. If not Manny Pacquiao, then who next for Floyd?
Good question. Everybody wants to fight Floyd Mayweather. It represents their biggest payday. A number of very, very good fighters out there around his weight class, in his weight class. We just have to wait and see what happens. We have Mr. Steven Espinosa say a few words.
This will come as a huge shock, I know, but there will be a replay of the pay-per-view a week from this evening. I think you've all gotten notice. You need the details. Chris DeBlasio can help you, but that will be replaying again Saturday, September 20th on Showtime. The Santa Cruz fight, as well as the main event, will be replayed on Showtime.
Would be a potential opponent, just like any of the other top welterweights out there. Amir Khan's a very good fighter.
Contact with Top Rank over Pacquiao, or do you let them come to him, or how does it go? What's going to be the chain of events here next month?
To be honest, I haven't even thought about it yet.
How would it work, though?
How would what work? It wouldn't be discussed in the press. That way it never will get done.
Leonard, what would be happening with the junior middleweight championship?
Repeat the question.
What will happen with the junior middleweight championship?
Where is it?
The 154 title. What will happen with that?
Well, you said what will happen to the...
defend it or retain the title?
I have no idea. Floyd's a proud champion, obviously, so, you know, that's his decision.
The question is because Richard Suleiman said recently that he wants to make Mayweather an American champion.
You said he wanted to make Mayweather
American
a very good champion. We're fighting in May. That's what I do know.
I have a question for Stephen. Stephen, in a couple of recent articles, Bob has been quoted in terms of the Pacquiao Mayweather fight. There's some secret negotiations going on between the two networks, and they're both on board. Is there any truth to that? Anything that you know of some secret negotiations?
Is there any truth to it?
Yeah, any truth to it.
I just say that Bob's got an active imagination sometimes. I'm not going to speculate who had lunch with whom. You know, the question was about the business negotiations and the
fight. My question's about whether you're privy to what the last one was actually that meeting with him in his home in L.A.
If I'm privy to what?
Les actually had a meeting with Bob.
Absolutely, I'm sure. And they've known each other 20, 25 years. They often meet. Is what a yes? Sure, they often meet. Sometimes they talk football, sometimes boxing. They often meet.
Ladies and gentlemen, 47-0, TBE, none other than the man himself, Money Mayweather.
First off, I want to thank everybody that came out for this event. You guys are truly amazing, because without the fans, I wouldn't be where I'm at today. We had a remarkable training camp. What else can I say? Maidana is a tough competitor. Rugged guy, extremely dirty, but he's rugged. The saga continues. There's a lot of great fighters out there. You know, I take my hat off to all the up-and-coming fighters and all the guys that's out there competing. Congratulations to my new champion. I know my voice is a little hoarse, but you know, when you fight 12 grueling rounds, you know, your voice can go hoarse, but you guys were remarkable. You know, I didn't do it by myself. I had a brilliant game plan, a brilliant team, and we gave the fans what they wanted to see tonight. And even in the 12th round, you know, Mickey Bay, one time he was in a big fight, one fight away from the championship fight. He went out there, of course, wanted to please the fans, but he went out there, he won 11 rounds and went out there and fought toe-to-toe and got knocked out. And I told him, you have to be smart. The smart fighters will last a long, long time being extremely smart. If I know I had to fight one and in the bag, why would I go out there and fight toe-to-toe in the 12th round? I'm not trying to mess my legacy up, you know, to get a sport over 30 years, didn't mess my legacy up, I just can't do it, you know. But social media, you know, thank you. All the fans that's on shots, my app, you gotta go get shots, of course. Everyone that's on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, that's following me. I think it's a total of 16 million. I appreciate everybody, but we had, like I said, everything was great. You know, I couldn't do it without you guys. And I'm pretty sure you guys got some questions. I know everybody wanna know what happened in the eighth round. Well, basically, this is what happened in the eighth round. We clinched, we came together, my hand was under him, and he bit my three fingers. So in the eighth round, my three fingers went numb. I couldn't feel my fingers no more throughout the fight. And my middle finger busted open through the glove when he bit me. So, you know, those type of things happen, but the fight had to go on, so that's what it was.
Was there a mark on the glove, Floyd? Did he break?
No, at first, when he first bit me, he acted like he didn't do it. Then he come back and said that I put my hand in his mouth. He bit me. But, you know, it's part of the sport, I guess. Like I said before, I think he need to move over to MMA. Because it's extremely dirty, tackle me. I mean, but it is what it is.
Floyd, you've seen, you know, by my estimation, fairly subdued the last, you know, this week, and even tonight. You don't seem like your normal joyous self after a big win. Has it been a rough week for you? Is it getting tough to promote these fights, you know, all the work that goes into it?
Oh, I mean, people think that it's just you train and you just fight. It don't work like that when you're at the pinnacle. It's something totally different. You know, you have to go from city to city, state to state. Sometimes we go out the country to promote an event of this magnitude. And you know, as far as when I do the commercials, I got to read, you know, 70 teleprompters. I mean, it takes a lot. It takes a lot, but this is what I chose to do, so it is what it is.
I mean, this hasn't been apparent that it's bothered you in the past. I mean, why now? Why, is it just the accumulation kind of making you get worn down?
Well, just being in the sport 18 years. You know, it's, you know, boxing is wear and tear on your body, of course. You know, it's a grueling sport. But, you know, like I said, you know, it's another fight. Another victory, and it's, you know, it's time to move on.
Two other questions for you, Floyd. You said in the ring you rated yourself a C-. You know, you landed 51% of your punches and kept him to 22%. What was it that you weren't happy with?
I know I felt a lot better this training camp, but I felt like I was better in the first fight than this fight. But I think my defense was a lot better, and my legs was a lot better, and you know, my dad gave me the game plan. He said, you know, when I come back to the corner, I know when I'm doing a good job because, well, actually, in the 11th round, because I can remember, you know, I got a sharp mind. My dad was like, in the 11th round, I want you to be sharp, just on your toes and move, box and be smart. He said, now, in the 12th round, that's when I want you to bite down and throw a lot of combinations and make it look good. But I said, I did it the other way. I flipped it around. I said, I'm gonna box in the 11th and then move in the 12th. Because I knew he was gonna be desperate by the time we reached the 12th round. And if you go back and look, hit him two body shots. The shot wasn't low. He knew the shot wasn't low. But he kept being extremely dirty to buy time. You know, I know that with experience. If you do dirty stuff, you can buy time if you get fatigued, and that's what he did.
He seemed to, I have two more questions now. He seemed to punch when you were punching. Was that causing you trouble? Because it seems like that, you know, when he was doing that, maybe he was landing some punches.
Real awkward style. No, he can't. No, let him, no, sorry, excuse me. No, give it back to him. That's my guy.
Richard, can you finish that answer, that one there?
Run it by me again.
Well, the other question I went on to was,
you surprised everybody by mentioning Pacquiao in the ring. Why did you do that? You've never done that before that I can remember.
Well, if you guys don't know, then ask me the question about Pacquiao. And what I said is, we don't know what the future holds for Floyd Mayweather as of right now. I think, you know, even in the past, when I look at the Pacquiao situation, when he fought Marquez, you know, I think he was too focused on Floyd Mayweather instead of focusing on the guy that was in front of him, and then you guys see what happened. So, I don't take nothing away from Maidana.
Yes, is it realistic?
Say again?
Is it realistic?
What's realistic is I'm 47-0.
Floyd right here. Floyd, right in front. Congratulations.
Thank you.
To follow up a little bit on what Kevin was asking about with regard to Manny Pacquiao, in your mind, what would it take to actually make the fight?
As of right now, you know, hey, Rich, how you doing? As of right now, I want to enjoy my time off. We don't know who we're going to be fighting in May. You know, we don't know what particular opponent. We're not in a rush, because once again, we're the A side. We're always going to be the A side. And we take our time. That's how we got to where we got to, you know. You know, me and Leonard been working together 18 years. You know, I'm pretty sure me, Leonard, and Al, and we'll come up with a brilliant game plan. And we're not sure what the game plan is.
Is part of the game plan, regardless of who the opponent is going to be, your plan? Leonard said it, but it's your boss here. He said you will fight again this coming May and then again September, but mainly your next fight in May. Is that the what you're hoping on?
Yeah, I'll probably fight in May. I may not fight again until September. It all depends on, you know, how I feel. I may fight again in September. You know, I don't think Showtime and CBS is rushing me. I think we're doing good numbers. You know, Steve, when we going again? When we going again? Yeah. And we had a good training camp. And you know, a lot of times you hear certain things about certain people. You know, Alex Reason, I had a chance to, you know, really meet. I've never met Alex Reason. You know. So we had a chance to meet in his training camp, and basically he came to my training camp and he showed me different stretches, and which helped. And he also told me, he told me basically what I should be eating today and yesterday. And so Alex Reese is a real cool guy. You know, a lot of times, you know, I've said things about Alex in the past, and he said things about me, but I never knew about Alex Reese. And one thing I can honestly say, he's never came to me in a bad way. He's always been a pretty cool guy when he came to training camp.
Floyd, can you talk for a minute about your decision to take the fight more to mid-ring than you did the first time when you were on the ropes a lot more?
Say it again?
Your decision to take this fight first to the middle of the ring right off the bat rather than fight off the ropes as much as you did the first fight?
Just being able to show the versatility, being able to change up, having experience, you know, I've been in big fights like this for so many years, so I know what it takes. You know, it's just, I can make adjustments instantly. And I think that's one of the pluses on my side.
The mayhem, if you will, in the eighth round where you got bit and your father's on the ring apron and you're yelling at Maidana and he's talking back to you. What did Kenny Bayless say to you during that time? And what's your perception of how he kind of handled this?
Kenny Bayless is a true professional. But what he said was, I can't see where he was bit at. I said, he bit me. I'm not just gonna scream if he didn't bite me. And then Maidana go back and say, well, you put your hand in my mouth.
Did you follow Ariza's diet? What did he tell you to eat?
Ariza, come tell him. Come on up. Ariza, come on up. He don't really want to come up a couple pounds.
Well, what did he tell you to eat? Did you do what he said?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, yesterday he said, basically, because normally, yesterday I ate steak, potatoes. Then I had my chef come cook also, but I ate steak, potatoes, and vegetables after the weigh-in. But then after a certain time, he said that I don't need to be putting beef in my body. So I mean like oatmeal, not too much fruit, because it'll cause diarrhea. And so, of course, he told me he wanted me, like granola and drinking fluids, more like water and Powerade, not the natural juices I'll be drinking. And I felt better, you know, I felt good. I was able to move my legs, even in the 12th round, you know, at the age of 37.
Hey Floyd, congratulations, now that you're at this point in your career, when you look at perhaps trying to get a Pacquiao fight done now, do you think that there are far less obstacles than there were all those years ago? Maybe the only obstacle being him needing to beat Algeria now?
I don't really ever think about Pacquiao. I don't even know him, actually. But I wish him nothing but the best. You know, that's not my focus. I got to where I got to, staying focused on Floyd Mayweather. I can care less about what Pacquiao does. I don't wish nothing bad on the man. But, you know, my focus is Floyd Mayweather. That's how I got to where I got to. If I was focused on any other opponents and what they do, I wouldn't be where I'm at today. So I try not to focus on no one else's business.
Do you feel like you're at the point in your career now where if you say, I want to fight Manny Pacquiao, it's going to get done?
Once again, I'm focused on Floyd Mayweather. I'm not focused on Pacquiao.
Well, that is you taking charge.
If it happens, it happens. You know, I just had this fight. You know, a good, solid, strong competitor tonight. And you guys can keep asking the same questions over and over again. You don't get the same answer. That's not my focus. My focus is I move when I mean, you guys ain't no access. I mean, I move when I want to, and how I want to. And, you know, my business motto is I'm my own boss. I call my own shots. You know, I think if Manny Pacquiao took the same approach, then he would be where I'm at. So it's obvious he's not doing something right.
Hey. Congratulations, Floyd.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Just two questions. The first one, Amir Khan was in here earlier, he was working on the Showtime broadcast, and he said he thought he saw signs of aging in you tonight. I wonder if you could discuss that. And whether you are feeling your age.
Mm-hmm.
And secondly, would you consider, we had an 80,000 packed Wembley Stadium earlier in the year for Frotch and Grove, would you ever consider coming and fighting in the UK at Wembley Stadium?
Amir Khan, he's a solid, good competitor, he's a good fighter. We don't know who I'm fighting as of right now. We don't really know. You know, I'm not rushing. If that fight happened to come my way, then we'll make it happen.
What about the science of aging and you feeling that at all?
I feel good. I feel good. I can't really say what age I felt. I felt like the winner. But Amir Khan's a good fighter, you know, of course. I mean, I think when Amir Khan was an amateur, you know, everybody was taking shots at Floyd Mayweather. I think when Amir Khan was an amateur, I was champion. And then when Amir Khan turned pro and he got knocked out, I was champion. And when Amir Khan got knocked out again, I was champion. And when he lost the belt again, I'm still champion. I'm still right here.
Thank you very much.
congratulations.
Thank you.
I think late in the third round, right before the bell, he caught you with a punch and seemed to knock you back a little bit. Were you hurt at all? No, you just off balance, and how did you adjust from that?
Caught me with a good shot. That's not a shot I never felt before. Caught me with a good shot. But I'm in good shape. You know, I'm built for this. You know, but I think that when I went to his body, when I went to his body twice, when I slid over and dumped to the body with the left, he was buying time. And we was ready to press the attack. I was ready to press the attack once I hit him with the second body shot. Then he told the ref, well, I need time, because he hit me with a low blow. Hit me with a good shot, though. You know, I don't take nothing away from him. Of course, he's a big puncher. He's 30, I don't know what his record is exactly, but he got 30-some knockouts out of, like, 34 fights. So, probably 32 knockouts, 31 knockouts. So, he's a strong guy.
Floyd, thank you. Congratulations. Considering this question, your answer. Comparing the two fights against Maidana, did you feel in any of the 24 rounds a good, solid shot about him?
Yeah, he's a strong guy.
For example, today in the fourth, in the final, in the third round, maybe?
And when he hit me with the shot, I felt it. I was like, okay, I've been here before. I know what it is. You know, suck it up. Go back to the corner, come back, regroup, go out there and do what I'm supposed to do. That's part of the fight game, you know? I mean, he's not going to land them shots like that all night. Of course he's going to land one. But as he's coming in, he's catching shots also.
Also, you get the time to make a kind of joke in the end of the round when Maidana get the wrong way to the corner. You were Sportman showing him, this is your corner. Was it,
I'm just entertained, having fun. I knew he was going to the wrong corner, so just having fun, making everybody laugh. You know, you gotta have a little sense of humor.
Floyd,
what? Oh, yeah.
After the first fight, you said that. After the first fight, you said that. Cotto and Canelo hit you a bit stronger than Maidana did. You still have the same appreciation? The same opinion?
There's a different type of strength. Maidana comes straight ahead. Cotto is just more physically stronger than Maidana. And Cotto punched harder than Maidana. But they both big punches, they both strong, but Cotto is all around a better fighter, but Maidana is more of a reckless fighter. Sure, that's it.
The tackle in the 10th round that ended up in the point deduction, you haven't been asked about that. Was that just frustration on his part? What were you seeing there?
He did it in the first fight. You know, this is not the first time this guy tackled me. He tackled me in the first fight. In the first fight, he tried to knee me. The list goes on and on. But like I said, I always find a way to win. When he bit my fingers in the 8th round, I came back to the corner and I told my father, of course, you know, you always got somebody that works for the commission. The commission is in the corner listening, because, you know, he got somebody from the commission in his corner. I have somebody from the commission in my corner. And what happened was my fingers went numb. I couldn't feel my fingers. So, and then my dad kind of got upset. You know, he like, hold on, I'm finna go over there and let them. I said, no, just relax, I got it. And then I said, wait, do this, don't worry. I'll make sure I do what I'm supposed to do. He was just buying time, because he was starting to get fatigued from the body shots. So, of course, like I said before, with experience, you know when the guy is trying to buy time.
Floyd, Ken Miller with the Sentinel newspaper. I had an opportunity to speak with Frank Robinson, who's here tonight watching you fight, a Hall of Fame baseball player, and ask him, what is it like to consistently be great? And what it is that you go through on a consistent basis to stay where it is that you are, knowing that each and every one of your fights are like Super Bowl level events. How do you sustain something like that without looking ahead or behind?
Well, what I do is, when I was younger, I used to read my articles. You know, I used to read about myself. When I used to be on the cover of a magazine, I used to go get the magazine and I read about myself. I got to a point where I blocked everything out. You know, I don't read, you know, I try to block everything out. When I was younger, any book that come out with me on the cover, or any book, you know, just, you know, that talks about me, any article, I'm reading articles every day. What comes out, you know, I Google what's going on today with me. But, you know, once I got, you know, I got older and wiser, what's more important is, you know, my family and me build my promotion company, me taking that to the next level, focus on different investments. Instead of, you know, I already know what I can do, so I ain't gotta read about myself because I know what I can do. You know, you just focus on different things outside the ring, not always focusing on my job. Because focusing on boxing all day, you can go crazy. So I leave my boxing in the boxing gym. And when I go home, I try to have a regular life, even though I can't go out, but I try. I want to thank everyone that came to Las Vegas. I want to thank everyone that covered the fight. I want to thank Showtime. I want to thank CBS. And of course, I have to thank the best hotel in the world, the MGM Grand. My all-access team, Maidana team, Maidana, Steven Espinosa, all the sponsors, my team, and everyone that came to training camp and supported me and supported this event. Not just me, we all appreciate you guys. Thank you.
Thank you.